There are two types of people. Type 1, the early bird. They like to wake up early. They prefer to do their workouts in the morning, and they feel more productive early in the day. By the time it gets dark, they start to feel tired and ready to sleep. Tomorrow is a new day. It's a different story for the second type of people, the night owls. Society was not designed for night owls. They feel like they've been hit by a truck, but they still have to work at the same time as the early birds. As the day moves towards its end, they start to feel more productive. It's getting late now, and they have to go to bed if they want to get enough sleep. And yet, they don't feel sleepy at all. Just one more YouTube video. In a world that celebrates the early grind, being a late sleeper is almost a rebellion. A rebellion that comes with consequences. Before we talk about the impact of your sleep type in your life, what exactly is a night owl and an early bird? And which of the two types are you? Well, people have a preference to sleep at different times of the day. This natural inclination is called your chronotype. Earlier I said there were two types of people, but that's not really true. It's true that you can be an early bird if you're very inclined to sleep early, or a night owl if you're very inclined to sleep late, but you can also be somewhere in the middle, which is the case for about 60% of people. Your chronotype depends on two things: your genetics and your environment. This includes your climate, your culture, and your habits. Are you unsure whether you're more of an early bird or a night owl? I shared a survey with my subscribers to estimate their sleep type. If you want to know your score and compare it with my audience, you can pause the video now and follow the instructions on the screen. Now, a disclaimer, this is not a scientific study, and I'm not certified to diagnose your sleep type. These results should only be interpreted as a general idea of how you compare against others. The survey had several questions. First, each person answered a few questions from a scientific questionnaire to measure their inclination for an early schedule. If you get a score of 45 or higher, then you're probably an early bird. If you get a score of 22 or less, then you're probably a night owl. 500 people participated. Let's see their scores. I confess that I was expecting a fanbase of night owls who watch YouTube videos until 3 AM, and yet only 8% got an evening type score, versus 7% who got a morning type score. The remaining 85% of participants were somewhere in the middle and had an intermediate score. Now that we have an estimate of your sleep type, let's see exactly what are the differences between early birds and night owls. As you would expect, early birds prefer to get up early and go to bed early. Their bodies reach their lowest temperature about 2 hours earlier than night owls. They have earlier cycles of cortisol and melatonin, two hormones related to stress and sleep, and they're linked to certain personality traits, such as conscientiousness, in other words, being thorough, careful, and efficient in tasks and responsibilities. For night owls, it's the opposite of everything I've just said, and also, they're more common in adolescence than in childhood or adulthood. They're associated to personalities with more openness to new experiences and ideas, they're more likely to be intelligent, and they're associated to a higher cognitive function. Now, these things are correlated to the chronotype. That doesn't mean they're caused by it. Just to make it clear, sleeping late will not make you any smarter, as far as we're aware. Despite some of these seemingly positive traits, night owls pay a price for their sleep type. We all have a biological clock in charge of our circadian rhythms. These rhythms regulate processes in our body like hormones, body temperature, and when you feel like waking up. But social commitments like work or school can clash with these rhythms, leading to a social jet lag. In other words, it's when society expects you to be awake, but your body expects you to be asleep. This mismatch can be particularly harmful for night owls. When I asked my subscribers how different their sleep schedule was on a working day compared to the weekend, 54% of the night owls said it was very different, versus only 9% of the early birds. It shows how jet lag night owls must feel during the week. When I asked them to rate the quality of their sleep on a scale of 1 to 5, the results were clear. early birds are way happier with their quality of sleep. Night owls face more insomnia. They are more prone to mood disorders, anxiety disorders, substance use disorders, personality disorders, sleep apnea, infertility, and more. They are particularly affected during adolescence, and on top of all of this, they have a lower life expectancy. Night owls face these health hazards in part because they don't fit into the morning schedules adopted by society. But has it always been like this? In 2016, a group of researchers studied the sleep of a tribe of the Adza people, a community of hunter-gatherers in Tanzania, in an attempt to understand our ancestral sleep patterns. They monitored the sleep of 33 tribe members during 20 days, and they discovered that, during that whole time, there were only 18 minutes where everyone was simultaneously asleep. There isn't a universally accepted theory on why night owls exist, but this study suggests that they might be the result of natural selection in the past. A tribe would have had better chances of survival if there was always someone awake to protect the others. And yet, society seems to judge night owls. I searched Wikipedia's online dictionary for proverbs in the most spoken languages to find what popular wisdom says about sleeping early or late. All my results follow the same pattern. Early bird catches the worm. Early to bed, early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy and wise. And other variations of the same message. Being an early bird is seen as healthy and responsible. Some studies show evidence of a social stigma against night owls. In an ideal world, we should be able to sleep at our own preferred schedule. During the COVID lockdowns, many night owls use the possibility of working from home to wake up later. But that's not really possible for everyone. Some people have to work early, not to mention shift workers who have even harsher schedules. Fortunately, there are things you can do if you want to adjust your sleep schedule. You can't control your genetics, but you can control your environment and habits. If you're struggling to fall asleep early, you can try the general sleep hygiene guidelines. Keep your wake-up times at the same time, even during the weekend. Try to get sunlight in the morning and avoid light exposure in the evenings. Avoid using your bed for anything other than sleep and sex. Avoid caffeine in the afternoon. Counterintuitively, you should not go to bed if you're not feeling sleepy, and you should not stay in bed if you can't fall asleep for long. And most importantly, don't overthink it. Everyone has bad nights of sleep every now and then, and trying too much to be a good sleeper is a sure way to become a bad one. But if that still doesn't work for you, then you can also seek professional help. There are therapies that successfully address these problems. Thank you for watching. If you like stories told with data and would like to support my work, consider leaving a like and subscribing to the channel. And thank you to our patrons.